Hi, I'm Vitanis, and today I'll show you how to extract data from any website using n8n. No coding required. Here's the plan. First, I'll show you the fundamentals with HTTP request and HTML nodes. Then, I'll show you a shortcut that handles both static and dynamic sites, so you can skip all the complexities of data extraction. By the end of this video, you'll know how to scrape any website using n8n and have the foundation to tackle your own projects. n8n lets you automate basically anything with its visual interface. It integrates with 500 plus tools out of the box, so you can skip the API learning curve entirely. That's exactly why it works so well for web scraping. Anyone can build a web scraping flows without writing a single line of code. Debugging and automatic retries are already built in, and since it's all drag and drop, what used to take weeks of coding now takes minutes or hours. But scraping is just one part of any workflow. You want to use that data somehow, and it couldn't be easier with n8n. It connects directly to powerful tools, LLMs, databases, whatever you need, all in one place. You can monitor e-commerce prices on a large scale, automate lead generation, build AI-powered dark web scanners, really any data-driven pipeline you can think of. If you're new to n8n, here's a quick tour of its interface so you know where everything lives. Once logged in, you'll see the essentials: your workflows list, saved credentials for connecting to services, your execution history, global variables, and data tables for storing data. On the left side menu, you've got more options for projects, admin panel, templates, insights, help section, notifications, and settings. Wondering whether cloud or self-hosted is the best choice? Here's the deal. n8n Cloud is perfect for businesses who don't want to manage their own servers. You get guaranteed uptime, SOC 2 compliance, and everything handled for you. It's perfect if you prioritize convenience and stability over cost. Self-hosted is for users who are comfortable managing their own infrastructure. Go for it if you prioritize absolute control, privacy, and unlimited executions over convenience. Plus, self-hosted n8n is completely free. You can run it on your own hardware at no cost or use a VPS or cloud server for a small hosting fee. My recommendation, if you're just testing things out and your free cloud trial already ended, install this self-hosted n8n using Docker. It's super simple and completely free. Simply install Docker Desktop, pull the latest official n8n image, and run it to create a container. Then, set up your owner account, get the license key, and activate it. And that's it. Next time, just run the n8n container to continue where you left off. Once your workflow is ready, you can export it into a JSON file and import it back into cloud or other self-hosted server to run automations 24/7. Before we dive into the actual scraping, let's get a basic n8n terminology straight. Triggers are special nodes that start your workflow. They watch for events like receiving a webhook, a scheduled time, or changes in an app. Every workflow must have a trigger. Nodes are the building blocks of your automation. Each one performs a specific task, like sending an email, updating a database, or transforming data. Workflows are complete automations you build by connecting nodes together. Data flows from one node to the next, creating a chain of automated actions. For web scraping in n8n, the workflow structure is highly configurable to your needs. But every web scraping flow must go through these basic steps. Firstly, set when and how the scraping starts. It can be manual, scheduled, or triggered by an event. Next, define the URLs you want to scrape. Thirdly, fetch the raw HTML content from the specified URLs. Then, extract specific data from the HTML using CSS selectors or convert it to Markdown for LLM processing. Optionally, you can format, filter, or structure the extracted data as needed. and lastly, save the data to databases, spreadsheets, or pass it to other nodes or workflows for further processing. Let's start with the simplest method, using the built-in HTTP request and HTML nodes. Add the trigger manually node. Then add the HTTP request node. Enter the URL to scrape. Let's use this demo e-commerce website that's specifically designed for web scraping practice. You can also pass a list of URLs and the node will take care of each, but we'll keep it simple for this video. Now, this bare minimum setup might work just fine for simple sites. But here's the thing. You want your requests to look like they're coming from a real browser. Otherwise, you can get blocked. That's where HTTP headers come in. In the HTTP request node, enable send headers. Select using JSON, then paste your HTTP headers that are catered to a specific website and resemble real browser request. For example, let's use these headers that mimic the Chrome browser on Windows. Send the request to get the HTML document. You also have additional node options you can enable for your use case. Batching lets you scrape multiple URLs at once. Make sure to add a batch interval to pace your requests. Redirects should always be enabled. This ensures you follow any URL, redirects automatically, and always scrape the final page. Pagination is crucial for multi-page results. Set this up so n8n could automatically fetch all pages instead of stopping at page 1. Timeout controls how long to wait for a response before giving up. It's useful for slow-loading websites. And finally, proxy is your secret weapon. This routes requests through proxy servers, helping you avoid IP blocks and bypass GR restrictions. For example, you can plug in Oxylabs residential proxies to keep your scraping flow running without interruptions. One important thing to know, this HTTP request method works great for static pages. But if a website loads content using JavaScript, you won't see that data in your results. So how do you tell if this site uses JavaScript? Well, here's a quick test. In Chrome, open Developer Tools, disable JavaScript through the Command menu, and refresh the page. Watch what happens. See how the star rating and platform name disappear? That means they are loaded dynamically with JavaScript and the basic HTTP request node won't capture them. Don't worry though, we'll cover solutions for JavaScript-heavy sites later in the video. For now, let's move on to extracting data from HTML. The HTTP request node grabs the page, but look at this raw HTML. It's a complete mess, right? You can't really work with this. You need to fix it with the HTML node. Add the HTML node and select Extract HTML Content. Now we need to tell it what data to extract. Let's get a title and price. Open your browser and go to the page in question. Highlight the title, right-click, and select Inspect to see it in the HTML. See how it's inside an H2 element? Well, that means our CSS selector is just H2. Let's verify this in the search bar. Type H2 and press Enter. Perfect, one match. Let's do the same for the price. The element has a price class, so the selector should be .price. Testing it shows we get the exact match. Back in n8n, add the selectors to your extraction values. Then execute the node to see the output. If you want to clean up the data, enable the trim values and clean up text options. This will remove extra white spaces and new lines. This works great for single items. But what about multiple listings? Let's scrape this product search page with 32 items. Add the HTML node. First, we need to grab all the product cards. In the HTML document, each listing has a product card class. So let's get back to n8n and enter the CSS selector. Set the return value to HTML and enable return array. Execute the node. Great, We got 32 items. The next step is to extract specific data from each product. Add another HTML node and point it to our product array using the JSON property field. Let's get the title and price. The title is in an H4 element and the price has the price wrapper class. Add both selectors and run the node. Done! All 32 products parsed into clean JSON. HTML parsing works great. You get exactly what you need, nothing more. But here's the catch. Websites change their HTML all the time. When that happens, your workflow breaks and you need to update every selector manually. Plus, if you're just analyzing scraped data with AI, this whole CSS selector approach is an overkill. For LLM flows, the best way is to automatically convert the raw HTML to Markdown format. This process strips all the HTML tags, attributes, and styling, and leaves you with a well-structured and readable representation of the page. Let's scrape this demo product page again. After the HTTP request node, add a Markdown node. Set the mode to HTML to Markdown. Then drag the scraped HTML output to the HTML field and execute this step. Look how compact that is compared to the raw HTML. This is perfect for AI analysis because it strips out all the unnecessary code and saves you tons of tokens. You can then send this Markdown straight to an LLM like Gemini or ChatGPT to analyze or summarize the data however you need. Remember those JavaScript heavy sites I mentioned earlier? Here's your solution. If you want a more powerful and reliable way to scrape in n8n, use Oxylabs AI Studio. It's an AI-powered tool that handles both static and dynamic sites with JavaScript rendering. You get 4 specialized apps covering your entire workflow. Automatic data parsing so you can skip parser maintenance, built-in proxy servers so your requests never get blocked, and effortless scaling no matter the volume. Grab a free API key and start scraping right away. No payment needed. Just sign up and copy your key from the API key page. If you are on n8n Cloud, you can install the AI Studio using the Notes panel. Just search for Oxylabs, select Oxylabs AI Studio, install Node, and then you can add it to your workflow. If you are self-hosting n8n, go to your settings, select Community Nodes, install a Community Node, enter n8n Nodes Oxylabs AI Studio, and then click Install. Now go back to the workflow, open the Nodes panel, and add the AI Studio to your workflow. Make sure to create a new credential and paste your API key. There are 4 resources you can use. Scraper extracts data from any web page. Crawler navigates websites to find and extract pages. Browser agent mimics human actions in a browser, and the search resource finds web results for any query. Let's see how this scraper resource works. You can enter any URL you want to scrape. For example, let's extract data from the AI Studio homepage. There are several options for the output format: Markdown, JSON, CSV, or screenshot. The JSON option extracts specific data based on a schema. You can easily generate one in the AI Studio website. Go to AI Scraper, enter your URL, select JSON, and describe what you need in plain English. Click Generate Schema, copy the JSON output, and paste it into your AI Studio node. If you expect the page to use JavaScript to load data, enable the Render JavaScript option, and then execute the node. Done! Feel free to explore other resources for your use case. And check out this pre-built n8n workflow that uses AI Studio for deep research. Link in the description. Here's what you need to know. n8n doesn't have a built-in browser control for handling dynamic web data. But don't worry, you've got a few options. The easiest route? Use a third-party tool like Oxylabs AI Studio, which has JavaScript rendering built right in. If you are self-hosting n8n, you can use Puppeteer or Playwright Community Notes. Just keep in mind these aren't officially verified n8n nodes, so they are only available for self-hosted instances. And if you want complete control, well, you can run Selenium Grid in Docker and connect to it via its REST API. This gives you full browser automation control, though it does require some technical setup. The code node lets you run custom JavaScript or Python scripts directly in your workflow. This is perfect when you are comfortable with these languages and need functionality that n8n doesn't have out of the box. Some powerful use cases may include complex parsing, advanced pattern matching, custom error handling, and so much more. Basically, if n8n can do it natively, you can code it yourself. Every n8n node comes with built-in error handling and retry logic. Head to the node settings tab and enable retry on fail. You can specify how many times to retry and how long to wait between attempts. The on error setting gives you three options. Stop the workflow completely, continue by passing the error as an output item, or continue by adding the error message to an extra error output field. Need more control? Use conditional flow nodes like if, switch, or filter, or write custom logic with code nodes. When scraping, it's important to be respectful of the websites you are accessing. Always add delays between requests. Aim for at least 3 to 5 seconds. Use the built-in wait node between HTTP requests to control your request frequency. Keep your batch sizes realistic. Don't try to scrape thousands of pages in one go. Break it into smaller chunks instead. If possible, avoid scraping during peak traffic hours when servers are under heavy load. And pay attention to 429 errors. That's the server telling you you are going too fast. If you see these, back off and increase your delays. n8n integrates with various storage solutions depending on your scale. For small projects, use the built-in data table for quick storage with no setup, or simply use Google Sheets. For medium scale, PostgreSQL or MongoDB can handle hundreds of thousands of records efficiently. Try managed services like Supabase or MongoDB Atlas for easy setup. Now, for large scale, you may want to integrate Google BigQuery or Snowflake. These are built to handle millions of records and complex analytics. And that's web scraping with n8n. If you want to go deeper, you'll find beginner web scraping tutorials and advanced guides linked below. Found this video helpful? Subscribe, like, and tell us in the comments what you'd like to see next. Thanks for watching.